President Marcos Jr. vows continued assistance to overseas Filipino workers and their families. In his latest blog entry, the president notes the Philippine government has been working to improve the country's ties with other nations that have OFWs. He adds the government could facilitate training programs for OFWs who wish to return home and work instead in the Philippines.
Ang aming approach ngayon para sa OFW ay tulungan hindi lamang yung OFW kundi pati pamilya na naiwan dito sa Pilipinas. Ang tanging maisusukli ko sa inyong hindi matatawarang kontribusyon sa ating lipunan ay masiguro ko ang inyong proteksyon, ang inyong kalagayan at ang kalagayan ng mga naiwan ninyong pamilya sa ating bansa.
The remains of slain overseas Filipino worker Julie Ranara have been laid to rest in Las Piñas Sunday morning. Ranara's brutal and tragic death sparked widespread condemnation. Her burned body was left in a desert in Kuwait by a 17-year-old son of Ranara's employer who confessed to the crime. Relatives and loved ones of the Filipino worker continue to cry for justice.
Since nang bata pa po talaga kami, magkakasama kami niyan, magkakatabi sa pagtulog, makulit. Hindi kami naniniwala since nga habang hindi po talaga namin makikita na siya po talaga yun. Kasi wala naman po talaga sa isip namin talaga na mangyayari po sa kanya yun. At hangad po namin ang hustisya para sa pinsan po namin.
Now the Philippine government vows continued assistance for Ranara's family.
Ang susunod na hakbang natin ay yung hustisya na hinihiling at kailangan na maibigay sa pamilya at kay Jollibee. Napakasakit ng nangyari sa kanila, no? Of course, yun pa rin, as I've said, yun ang gusto nila eh, hustisya. Hindi lang isang tao, hindi lang yung pamilya nila ang umiyak, hindi napakaraming tao. Nasaktan dito ang ating buong bansa.
Business tycoon Roberto Ongpin has passed away. He was 86. Ongpin died in his sleep on February 4th in Balasin, the exclusive island resort he built as part of a wide portfolio of investments in real estate and gaming. His remains will be brought to Manila, but there's no details yet on the wake. Ongpin had long been regarded as one of the Philippines' wealthiest businessmen. Forbes magazine named him last year as the 23rd richest Filipino with a net worth of over 44 billion pesos, or $830 million. He served as the Minister of Commerce and Industry during the regime of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. A United Nations Special Rapporteur set to begin today a four-day trip to the Philippines. But the country's Justice Department clarifies Morris Tidbalbins will visit as a forensic pathologist and not in his capacity as a rapporteur on extrajudicial killings. Justice Secretary Jesus Remulla says Tidbalbins will help capacitate the country's doctors. He'll also meet with Remulla, Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, and officials of the Philippine National Police, Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, and the National Bureau of Investigation. The Justice Department says Remulla personally invited the UN official, whose visit comes 2 weeks after the International Criminal Court reopened an investigation into the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. A Philippine Navy warship experiences firsthand China's aggressive actions in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Coast Guard says BRP Andres Bonifacio was tailed and monitored by two Chinese Coast Guard vessels and two Chinese maritime militia boats. According to Coast Guard spokesman Commodore Armand Balilio, this happened while the Philippine ship was conducting a patrol and search mission within the country's 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone. Balilio adds, the Chinese vessels even conducted an intercept course towards the Navy warship. Chinese ships in disputed waters are also known to shadow or harass Philippine fishing vessels.
Now, fishermen from Zambales are appealing to President Marcos to help them receive compensation from a Chinese-owned vessel. The new Masinloc Fishermen's Association says they lost nearly 900,000 pesos in potential earnings and equipment after a Chinese coal vessel, identified as HC Glory Hong Kong, dragged their fish aggregating device despite repeated warnings. The group's president, Leonardo Quaresma, says they sought the assistance of the Coast Guard and the Bureau of Customs to help mediate and meet with the boat captain, but they were not given a chance. Quaresma adds the compensation offered to them was a paltry sum of just $500. The Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson Commodore Armand Badillo said they are investigating the matter.